Thank you. Let me first thank the organizers for the invitation to give the talk. So let me give an introduction to Cartan geometry. Okay, so one example is projective structure. So let us recall the projective structure on Riemann surface, which has been defined, talked about many times. But I want to formulate it in a, so that I can, that can be generalized. Okay, so X compact surface. Compact is not necessary, oriented surface. Infinity. Recall that in one lecture, the projective structure was defined as a coordinate charge, pi, ui, open sets in x, to cp1, says that ui's cover x and phi inverse pj is the restriction of a Mobius transformation of CPR. That's an element of PSL to R. PSL to C acting on. Okay, some protest? Okay. No. Another definition was this, that it was defined as f comma phi, the rho, where rho is a, and of course there's a equivalence relation. Two such things will be equivalent if their union is also satisfy the same data. And a projective structure is an equivalence class. F rho, where rho is a homomorphism from phi 1 of x to PSL to C. And F is a invariant map from X tilde to CP1, phi1 X equivariant. That means F composed gamma is equal to rho gamma composed F for all gamma in phi1 of X. Here also there is a projective structure is an equivalence class, because if you conjugate by element of representation by element of PSL to C and change up gamma x tilde accordingly, you, that is also this the same projective structure. So it is an equivalence class. Okay. So now let's continue with this from this definition. So let us look at this object. So on CP1, we have the trivial vector bundle of rank 2. By CP1, I mean projectivization of C2, namely lines in C2, space of all lines in C2. So now if you projectivize it, you get CP1 cross CP1, CP1, you have the projection of the first vector. Now, what is the structure it has? So it is a trivial bundle, so it has a flat connection, namely the trivial connection. Then there is a diagonal sitting inside it. So there's flat connection, namely a trivial connection and a diagonal. Now, PSL 2C acts on CP1. Now, diagonal. The diagonal, and it has the trivial connection. Now we know that CP1 acts on PSL2 acts on CP1, but note that the entire thing is equivariant under the action of PSL2C. So when I pull back, the action this because it is equivariant, the action of pi1x continue to act on it. So let us take f upper star of this bundle. Let us call give a name to this bundle. Say capital P. F upper star P. Trivial connection. Let us call it nub null naught. And yeah, I should say something. This diagonal is a section. Call it S, the diagonal. Diagonal is a section of this bundle, right? So F upper star P, F upper star nub null naught, and I have F upper star of S. So I have a projective bundle, a flat connection and a section. Now it is equivariant by the action of the pi 1 of x. So I quotient everything by pi 1 of x. So what will get? I'll get a projective bundle, call it PSL2, PSL, a flat connection, I'll call it nabla. Now let us call it projective bundle, so let us call it give a notation P tilde. EP, projective bundle. Now that's not a good notation, P tilde. Projective bundle, a flat connection and a section. Let's call it S naught. I'll get this object on X. Because it is equivariant, this map is equivariant. The two things, this map is equivariant and this whole diagram is equivariant under the action of PSL2C. So I can pull it back and take the quotient. So I get a flat bundle, projective bundle, section. Now this has some property. Namely, there is a second fundamental form. So everything is pulled back from here, so you have to look at what is the second fundamental form here. The second fundamental form is an isomorphism here, because the diagonal is transverse to the horizontal space sections. Diagonal is transverse to horizontal sections. Or this flat connection, trivial connection. Namely, you have this P1 cross P1, you have the diagonal. If you take a point, you take horizontal vector, you take a tangent vector here, and you take lift it, using the section, you take a vector V here in the CP1. And suppose this vector is a V tilde lift. Now you can take its horizontal and vertical components. The second fundamental group is form is sending this vector to this vertical component. And this map is identity map because it's diagonal. So the second fundamental form is an isomorphism. And this is just that quotient that the same locally the same picture. The second fundamental form is an isomorphism. Because simply it is that's true for. Now this object, which is obtained from projective structure, is equivalent to projective structure. If you want to get back the projective structure from here, you get as follows. Since it's a flat connection, you can locally trivialize it, the bundle over a simply connected set. Any flat bundle on a simply connected set, your manifold is. So if U in X is a simply connected, take a point x naught in U. So you have this flat principal bundle, flat vector bundle, maybe a projective bundle. Now P tilde restricted to U is simply becomes, because using the flat connection, p tilde at the 5 hat of x naught times u. Now, you have the section here. So you restrict the section here. So you have this section here, u to this. And so now you can map to the second factor, p tilde of x naught. You have this section here, and I project it. This is a projection. So I'm getting a map from the u to the projective space CP1, which is isomorphic to CP1. So I get a, these are the, I can use them as the projective coordinates. They will satisfy the transition for property. So I'll get back that from here. So I started with this definition, got this, and if you, from this, I trivially get back these projective coordinates. Okay. But I'll still want to continue on this. There's, okay, now take the group. I'll still continue with this description. Take PSL to C. This is space of lines, so you have the parabolic subgroup. Let's call it Q, which fits one line. So you can think of this image of these matrices. This is your Q. So PSL2 mod Q is P1, CP1. Now from, this is a projective bundle. From that I can construct a principal PSL2 bundle, E. So what is a principal bundle? Principal is a fiber bundle, such as a principal bundle for a group G is a fiber bundle, such that the group acts on a total space with the base being the quotient and the action on the fibers is free and transitive. So how do you get the principal PSL2 bundle from this? You take the P1, CP1, fix it, and take space of all isomorphism to this isomorphisms with the fibers of this. You understand? This is a fiber bundle with fibers at P1, isomorphic to P1. I fix a P1, take a standard P1, and I take space of all isomorphism from P1 to the fibers of this. So what will be the, so it will be a, it will be a map to the base X, because given a, which fiber it is I'm identified with, I have the isomorphism to that point. But how two isomorphisms differ? Two isomorphisms differ by the automorphism of this. From this standard CP1 to have the map to the fiber, I have two isomorphisms. Two isomorphisms differ by an automorphism of this CP1, and that is PSL2C. So this becomes automatically a fiber principal bundle for the group PSL2C. This is a space of all isomorphisms of. Isomorphism from CP1 to fibers of the bundle P tilde. So there's a natural correspondence. Conversely, given a PSL2 bundle, I can get a projective bundle by quotienting by this subgroup. The full group acts on the space, on the principal bundle. If I quotient by this, I get a projective. Anyway, so now this connection by the same standard thing, that the connection on this, since this is identified a projective bundle, PSL2 bundle, this connection defines a connection on the, so normalize a connection on it. Now what this section S is a reduction to P Q. S is a reduction of structure group EQ of ESL to C. Yes. The principal Q bundle says that an action commute, action of Q on this and this commute. Q is a subgroup of PSL to C, so it acts still a continuous track here. Now, what is this? This I said that this is the space of isomorphism of the standard P1 to the fibers. Now, you fix a point on the standard P1, namely, it's a point line given by the, say, x-axis. Now, you take, instead of taking all isomorphism of the fiber on the CP1 to these fibers, you take isomorphism that takes the fixed point on CP1 to the evaluation of the section, right? Instead of taking all isomorphism from this to the fiber, standard CP1 to the fiber, once I fix a point, once and for all I fix a point, and here there's a point, I take isomorphism that takes this point to this. So that's the principal Q bundle. That's it. Now I have the following structure now. So now a connection on a principal bundle is a Lie algebra one form. So what do you want to transform? Isomorphisms from the standard P1. No, that is the PS transformation. I'm not taking automorphism. I'm not talking about the gauge group. I'm not taking bundle automorphism of this bundle. I'm taking. Yeah, so I earlier I take all isomorphism, I take all isomorphism that takes this point to that point. Subclass of isomorphism. Okay. So now. Okay. So now recall that a connection is a Lie algebra on one form. So there are various descriptions of connections on principal bundle. So it's a Lie algebra holomorphic one form. So you have a map from tangent space of PSL to the Lie algebra. You remember this is connection, is connection if it has the following condition. On restriction to each fiber, it has to be coincide with the moral Cartan form because the group action of the group on PSL to C, a free and transitive action on a group on a space will identify the vector tangent vectors with the Lie algebra by the action. So that is called the moral Cartan form, namely the identification of the tangent to the Lie algebra. So on the fibers, this should coincide with the moral Cartan form, and this should be equivariant for the action of PSL to C. On PSL to C acts on here E, so it acts on a tangent model, and here it acts by the conjugation. So this map should be a connection on a principal bundle is a Lie algebra form such that fibers, on the fibers, it is a moral Cartan form and it is equivalent. So I have a form like this, so let us call it theta. Now what I can do is that I can restrict theta to, let's call this inclusion map I. I consider I upper star of theta. This is a map from TEQ to so what are the properties it has? It is still, of course, just as before it was equivariant, fiber-wise moral Cartan, it is fiber-wise, it coincides with the moral Cartan form. It will be equivariant as before, but it is not a Lie algebra form of the principal one. It is taking a some other bigger Lie algebra. That's the only thing. Otherwise, it is all the properties of connection, but it is not a connection because connection should take values in the Lie algebra of the structure group. Structure group is Q, but it is taking Lie algebra values in the bigger Lie algebra. But now, I note that this is an isomorphism. So it has load of dimensions are same because Q has dimension one less than the X. So tangent, suppose dimension of the, this is a 2, Q, dimension of Q is 2. So this is dimension is 2 plus 1, 3 plus EQA's dimension is 2 plus 1, see? 2 plus 1, and T of that is twice that. And here it is 3 and 3. So dimensions are same. Now note that fiber-wise, Banach-Cartan form. So each fiber it captures the Lie algebra of the Q. So what is left is only one dimension. But one dimension, this is also captured because of the following fact that this is second fundamental form is isomorphism. So this, because you can easily see that this immediately implies, because you take a vector here, it cannot lie in EQ. It has to go out because EQ is second fundamental form means that EQ is not preserved. So if you tangent vector, it has to go out of EQ. And if you as soon as it goes out of EQ, it picks up a vector in from the other Lie algebra. And as soon as it picks up another extra vector, it is surjective because only one vector is left. One dimension is left. So this is an isomorphism. So equivalently projective structure can be defined as follows. So this again captures the entire. So what is the object? I have a principal EQ bundle. Take a Riemann surface, a principal EQ bundle. Take a, say, Riemann surface, I take a holomorphic principal EQ bundle, take a, let us I star theta, let us call it something theta prime. Theta prime is a form. Holomorphic form with values in the Lie algebra. So I'm defining a projective structure again. A principal SL2C bundle, Q is SL2C, Q is the parabolic sub, a principal Q bundle, a holomorphic one form on EQ with values in the this Lie algebra, such that satisfying three conditions. One, on fiber is a Madhav-Cartan form. It is the Madhav-Cartan. Two, Q equivariant. Because Q is acting on Lie algebra of SL2C by conjugation. And three, most important, and very important, theta prime is an isomorphism. Easy to check. So we obtain from a projective structure to this, but this is equivalent to defining a projective structure. We'll see slightly later how this in a more general context, when you define Cartan geometry, how from this theta prime I get back a connection on the Q bundle to I can construct SL2C bundle, PSL2C bundle by structure group, because one group is sitting inside another group. Q is sitting inside PSL2C and have a principal Q bundle, so by extension of structure group I get a principal PSL2C bundle, and this defines a connection, and that is this this nabla. So that's how I go back from here to there. So I can, I'll still continue with this. I still want to modify this. Recall that Atiyah bundle of a principal bundle is a tangent bundle of the total space quotiented by the group. So if E is a principal G bundle on X, so Atiyah bundle for EG is tangent bundle of EG quotiented by G. Adjoint bundle of EG, you take the vertical tangent space. Call it pi, kernel d pi, quotiented by g, This is also the vector bundle associated to EG for the adjoint action on the Lie algebra. And so you get an exact sequence, 0 going to add EG. Because this is sitting inside this, vertical sitting inside full tangent space, at IEG, and tangent bundle of X. For any complex manifold, you can define this. And recall that the connection is a splitting of the connection, at exact sequence. There's another way, various way of defining connection. A connection, a holomorphic connection is a holomorphic splitting of the at exact sequence. This is called RTI exact sequence of this exact sequence. Why? When you have a splitting, in the principal bundle level, you get a G equivariant map of the tangent space. And that you declare to be the horizontal space. That's how that's the relationship between RTI splitting of RTI example. Speaking about the exact sequence and connection. So this theta prime becomes a homomorphism from by taking quotient by H from both sides, quotient by Q from both sides. So TQ by quotient by Q becomes the RTI bundle for Q. And if I quotient it by the, it becomes the RTI bundle, adjoint bundle for EH. EQ. And let us call, with this notation from here, let us define E, PSL to C, PSL to be the principal, associated principal bundle, namely EQ, SL, PSL to C, over Q. So Q acts on this action on this side, you take by the quotient diagonal, twisted diagonal action, that becomes a principal PSL to C panel. Because when you are acting, you are using the action on the left, but the right action is still left, unused, so this has action of PSL to C and it becomes a principal PSL to C panel. And this becomes, when you quotient this by the Q, it becomes adjoint bundle for that. So EPSL to C. Adjoint of so this is an isomorphism. So this now I'm again reformulating this statement such that I have this exact sequence, right? Because Lie algebra of Q sits in Lie algebra of PSL to C, so that induces that gives the that inclusion gives an inclusion of associated bundles. So there I'm writing just, and I'm writing just writing the parent here. Now you have the RTI exact sequence for instead of G, I'm using the Q here. So it has add. Quotient is the tangent model. So this homomorphism, we have the constructed the theta prime, has a property that on this here it gives identity map. So here theta prime is an isomorphism, says that on this it is identity map, so it produces isomorphism here. So from the projective structure, I have constructed this. And again, this is equivalent to projective structure. Projective structure means that a principal equibundle Q, this is again definition of projective structure, equivalent definition of projective structure. A principal Q bundle over X and let us call it phi. And a holomorphic isomorphism phi says that which is identity on Again, you can see that just from this, you can recover projective structure. The way I came back, it is reversible. You can quite straightforward. Now I am in a position to define what is a Cartan geometry. I mean, I could have defined right away, but I think this will now be a straightforward generalization once we look at it into this way. H containing G, complex Lie groups. Y, complex manifold. A, holomorphic Cartan geometry. On Y, is the following. One, a holomorphic principle H bundle EH before I write two. Once I have a principal G bundle, I have an H bundle, I have a G bundle by extension of structure, right? By EG is defined to be EH. You have the H acting here and on the left, and it's a twisted quotient. And this quotient G continues to act on the right, and left action, right action commute. So the quotient will have action of the right action G. So it will be a principal G bundle, which I'll call EG. An isomorphism, holomorphic isomorphism. Phi from RTR of EH to add EG, adjoint bundle. This is the Lie algebra bundle associated, vector bundle associated to the Lie algebra, to EG for the adjoint action of G on its Lie algebra. So this is basically EG times. A holomorphic isomorphism says that of the diagram. Let me write the diagram. Okay, 0 going to add EH. IH. We have all these objects already. Tangent bundle of Y, holomorphic tangent bundle, that we have already seen how we do. And the Lie algebra of H, inclusion of the Lie algebra of H into the Lie algebra of G will give me a injective IDH. And I write down the quotient for convenience. Have a phi. It should satisfy the condition that is identity. You get an isomorphism. Such that restriction to add EH is the identity one. That's it. That's the definition of it. Now, when G is equal to X, the dimension of Y is 1. G is equal to KSL to C. And H is Q, the parabolic subgroup. Then this is a projective structure, as you saw. So this is a justification for the definition. I should keep it. Now, let us prove a small lemma. this phi induces a this Cartanium phi induces a holomorphic connection. So this is, I'm trying to explain. The special case, it will be this. I mean, after all, we know that the PL2 button has a flat connection. So, but how this defines a flat connection? So the general situation, how we define, how we produce a flat connection, this isomorphism. Atia of EG, because of its extension of structure group, it is Atia of EH, direct sum of add of EG, quotiented by add of EH, while any vector V sits inside as let us give a name, let us call it alpha. Alpha V, comma, minus V. Because add of EH is contained in here, so add of EG, so I can write it. And alpha is the homomorphism. And now, from here, add of EG, I have a map. Alpha V comma W goes to V comma W here. This is V RTIH to this pi of V plus W. Now, since it is identity, you can see that this put it inside this, and then you apply this map, this goes to zero. So I get a map from the quotient bundle. This goes to zero by this map, because you are writing an opposite sign and then adding it. And here is identity, so it cancels off. So you get a map here. And such that when you compose with the inclusion of adjoint bundle, RTI bundle, you get identity. So then, go here and come back, you get identity. Because anything will go as V comma 0. V here will go to V comma 0. And they'll come back at 5V, which is same as if I do. Huh? Yeah, alpha is this map. Somewhere I wrote down. Alpha is this map. RTIH to RTIH. Adjoint EH to RTIH. So I get a splitting of the RTI exact sequence for EG. So that means by definition, that's a connection on EG. So it's a very simple argument that I'm getting a connection on EG. And this is a holomorphic connection. Now, a Cartan geometry. So curvature, once a connection, I have a, I can talk about the curvature. You can not recall that curvature is a section of add EG tensor omega to y. Curvature of it, of this connection, is a section, holomorphic section of now. A Cartan geometry is called integrable if this curvature vanishes. Or flat, I think it's also called flat. A Cartan geometry is called flat or integrable. Both the terms are used if the curvature vanishes, if the above curvature Now, in the Riemann surface case, it vanishes automatically because there is no holomorphic two form. So in dimension one, Cartan geometry is flat. Of course, there is only one type of Cartan geometry. Anyway, so now, if the Cartan geometry is flat, then we have developing map. Namely, as before, we can define integrable flat Cartan geometry same as, just as, I mean, I remember that projective structure is the equivalence class of pairs, right? We said F comma rho, where rho is a homomorphism and F is a embedding from the map from the universal cover to this, I mean, which is a local biholomorphism such that equivariant, pi 1x equivariant. The same definition works. Flat Cartan geometry is same as pairs, I'm writing the same way, F comma rho. Is that F is a x tilde universal cover to rho is a homomorphism from pi 1 of x to g, and F is a local biholomorphism x tilde to g mod h local biholomorphism, which is pi 1 of x. I wrote y actually, so which is pi 1 of y equivalent. Namely, same as before, that F composed with gamma is same as rho gamma composed with F for all gamma in pi 1 of pi. But in higher dimension, there are non-integrable Cartan geometry. Okay, so this is a long introduction, definition of Cartan geometry, rather not introduction, definition. Now, let me keep this. Now, let us quickly recall Mandelbaum's branch projective structure. And before I say that, you see there in higher dimensions there will be huge obstruction for. There are in all Riemann surfaces as projective structure with higher dimension existence of Cartan geometry is strong restriction. For example, take any compact complex projective variety, say, which is simply connected. So now, a quick example, suppose it's simply connected. So now, if it has a flat Cartan geometry, then it will have to map to G mod H. And but it is local biholomorphism and Y is simply connected, so it has to be an isomorphism. It's a very strong condition. So, if a compact complex manifold, a simply connected compact complex manifold is a flat G comma H structure, then it is G mod H. If it's nothing, so this gives a very strong obstruction. Now let us branch projective structure. I quickly tell you what is the difference. When you define using coordinates, local coordinates, you allow coordinates to be not biholomorphism but ramified map. On x tilde to In the when you define in terms of the, you map from the universal cover to CP1, in your, you take it is a local again that is local by homomorphism. There you instead of allow ramification. Then in the third definition was in terms of let us forget those intermediate definitions. When you define in terms of here. Only require you drop the condition. This is an isomorphism. This is isomorphism on open set, but you don't require to be isomorphism everywhere. So if it is failed to be an isomorphism, it fails to if isomorphism was some finitely many points. Of course, if a non-zero homomorphism of vector bundles is isomorphism somewhere. It is isomorphism outside some finitely many points. So outside some finitely many points, isomorphism, but you don't require that this to be isomorphism. So that's a branch projective structure. So now, once you have this and this formalism, the branch Cartan geometry is again clear. What should be the definition? You just drop this condition that isomorphism. You say instead of isomorphism, replace it by isomorphism on open subset. Isomorphism somewhere. If it is somewhere, then it has to be isomorphism open subset. Because isomorphism being isomorphism is an open condition. Isomorphism on an open subset instead of isomorphism of everywhere. So that is branch. This is branch Cartan geometry. I am not changing anything. This is the definition of branch Cartan geometry. Now, here I said that there is a strong obstruction for existence of Cartan geometry. At least I convinced you for the simply connected case, there is no flat, they hardly ever you can get a flat Cartan geometry, because if it is flat Cartan geometry on simply connected manifold, complex manifold, then it has to be G mod H itself, homogeneous space. So if a compact complex manifold which is not homogeneous, it cannot have a flat branch Cartan geometry. Cartan geometry simply connected with homogeneous, which is not homogeneous, cannot have a flat Cartan geometry. Write it down, maybe. You see me. Not homogeneous, not holomorphically homogeneous. Does not admit flat. So now, I want to say that the branch Cartan geometry, see, branching allows some room, right? Instead of isomorphism, we require to be isomorphism only over global isomorphism, isomorphism on just on open set. So now I want to show. Any complex projective variety, smooth complex projective variety admits a branched Now, you have the CPN, CPD. It has a projective structure standard, just like CPN. It has a tautological standard projective structure, which is the group is, the two groups are PSL D plus 1C. Contains a maximal parabolic, which fixes automorphisms of CPD, which fixes a pop point. This is a parabolic subgroup. So if for this pair, you had a projective Cartan geometry of this. Of this pair, for this and this subgroup, it is again a higher dimensional projective structure. Obviously, that is called higher dimensional projective structure. So CPD has a tautological projective structure. So now, suppose Y is, since it is suppose the dimension of Y is D. Now it is. Not difficult to show that standard that any complex projective variety of dimension D has a finite map to. It will have some ramification divisor. So now on this, I have this tautological branch projective structure, projective structure. I can pull it back, so I'll get a branch projective structure on this. Branch projective structures can be pulled back by ramified maps. By maps, it should be the same dimension, generically isomorphism, ramified map. Generically with respect to domain, I mean, for each point, my generically locally isomorphism. I said that may have ramification. I have to go back here to explain something. Here the condition was that this is on an open set is an isomorphism. The question is where can it fail? I have a vector branch of same dimension. You see that they have the same dimension because on an open set is an isomorphism. So a vector branch of same rank on a manifold, complex manifold, holomorphic vector on the same rank. Where it can fail to be an isomorphism? It can fail to isomorphism on a divisor. Besides, it's not very arbitrary set. It can only be a divisor. Like as follows. Suppose, I mean, quickly, V to W, which is same rank bundle, says that it is not isomorphism everywhere, but open set is isomorphism. On somewhere, at some point, it is isomorphism. You take a top exterior product of W, this. Call it beta. You have this gives a section of this line bundle. Top exterior of this to top exterior, you have a map, and this is a line bundle. And this top exterior product gives a section of that. This homomorphism bundle, this gives a section of this line bundle, and this fail to be non-zero, exactly where it fails to be an isomorphism. If it is a top determinant level map is non-zero, then it has to be an isomorphism. Otherwise, conversely. So, but on where a section of a line bundle can vanish, it vanishes on a divisor, right? So, the vanishing of this divisor, of this section is precisely where this homomorphism failed to be an isomorphism. So it failed to be an isomorphism for on a divisor, and that is called the ramification divisor of the branch projective structure. Ramification divisor. Branch projective structure. Let us call phi. This is the divisor where phi fails to be an isomorphism. What to tell? What I'm describing this branch projective structure definition, except all joint to arc with sodium dimensions. All I'm going to say. Okay. So here, the branch. Branching divisor of the pulled back branch projective structure is precisely the branching divisor of delta. So you see, branching opens up. If you allow branching, then there are many more projective branch projective structure. Then I want to. Now I want to say something. I want to say that as before, phi induces a flat connection or a holomorphic connection on EG. From here I continue. Connection on EG. The proof is exactly same, but you just you remember at EG is equal to at EH. This part remains same at EG. Presented by RDH. Again, this any V goes to sits in both sides. So I'll just writing the same notation, V comma minus V. And here you have mapped to add EG. V comma W basically V plus W, same as before. I'm forgetting, I want us to be more precise like as before, but what I'm to say is that same map, same description goes. So add EG has a holomorphic connection. So curvature of a branch projective structure still makes sense. So we'll call a branch projective structure is called flat. If the curvature vanishes. Again, if you have a flat branch positive structure, then locally you can have this developing map, which are now not locally biholomorphism but ramified. For flat, in flat case, locally ramified, local developing map, locally defined developing maps. This implies locally developing map that may have branched. This is not local isomorphism. There's a branching is there. But up to that, a compact scalar manifold is called Calab i-Yau. If C1 of M is equal to 0, same as by Yau's theorem of Calabi's conjecture, it has a, M has a Ricci flat structure. Long time back, several years, quite a few years back, where with Benjamin McKay, myself, and independent Dumitrescu. Prove the following. M, a Calab i-Yau admits a projective structure, a Cartan geometry, if and only if M is an unramified cover covering of a compact torus, compact complex torus. Okay, now Cartan geometry on a Calab i-Yau manifold is flat. So the curvature vanishes. So, let me formulate it slightly more precisely, differently. Let's take simply connected. Oh, sorry. Simply connected is a, it's a natural thing because by this Berger's theorem, we know that any Calab i-Yau is product of simply connected Calab i-Yaus, genuine simply Calab, which is holonomy, they see when they're simply connected. Hyperkala, they're simply connected, and torus quotients. So if you forget about the torus quotients, what did I see? I wrote it wrongly. It's covered by covering of a torus is a cover. Yeah, so except these cases, the covering of torus, other Calab i-Yaus are simply connected. If you pull SUN holonomy, then simply connected hyperkalar SP connected. Covering up quotient of torus are the only thing. So let us take as a principal case that is simply connected, then it is flat. So then we get a map from, since it's simply connected, we get a map from G mod H. It's a covering map, unramified covering. Precise description, you have this. And if you have a ramified covering, then of course you can get a branch projective structure. Converse is true. By this fact, that I can pull back a tautological branch projective structure to this ramified covering. So in particular, F is non-algebraic, M is not if it is non-algebraic, then you see it cannot have a map because this is a it has no suppose no a non-algebraic factor. I mean it's not a see, Calab i-Yaus can have two types. One is algebraic and non-algebraic, even for instance, K3 surface. They have some projective and some just a compact scalar, not projective. So since this is an algebraic object, you cannot have a ramified covering if it is not algebraic. Oh, my time is over. If M is non-algebraic, then there is no. Branch-based structure.